After meeting with Steve and hearing details about what he can recollect from his traumatic experience, Joan is now ready to begin his regressive hypnotherapy session, with the team monitoring from the next room.
All right. Are you comfortable?
I guess, yeah.
All right, just take a nice, deep, easy breath for me. Exhale slowly. Allow your body to begin to relax completely. Imagine that it's causing your eyelids to become heavier now than they were before. Very relaxed, very comfortable, but heavier and heavier. From the top of your head to the bottoms of your feet. Now it's caused your eyelids to become so heavy, so drowsy, so sleepy, that in a moment when I ask you to try to open your eyes once again, you find that this time your eyes no longer want or need to open. So heavy, it's almost as though they're sealed shut. And you find that the harder you try to open, the more impossible it becomes. When I ask you to try to open your eyes, you only have to try to open for a second. When you find you're unable to get them open, it's okay. You were the one that moved all the heaviness there, so just relax further and deeper. Eyelids so heavy, so drowsy, so sleepy. The harder you try to open your eyes, the more impossible it becomes. It's like they're stuck closed, almost like they're sealed shut. Steve, try to open for a second for me. Very good. Now, Steve, we know that that very powerful part of your mind is open. I'd like for you to begin to picture yourself on the porch of a little cabin. That cabin is very comforting and feels like a safe place to you. Mm-hmm. All right, so when I touch your hand, if we ever need to, the minute I touch your hand, you'll immediately be at that safe place, at that wonderful, safe cabin. Now, let's go to that time in your life when you were 17. So you start walking. Then you told me that you come to a wall on the highway. What happens next?
It lights up.
The wall lights up?
Yeah.
How does the wall light up?
Bright.
Where's that brightness coming from?
A spaceship.
A spaceship?
Can you describe it?
A bright light comes out.
Comes down on you?
Yeah.
Okay.
And
what comes next?
We're in some kind of room.
You're in a room? Okay. What's in the room?
Somebody.
Some person?
No. Some person.
It's not a person.
Oh.
Can you describe this?
Long head, neck.
A long head and a neck?
Yeah.
Okay.
Got big eyes, too.
Big eyes?
Yeah. It's scary.
Scary, I bet. Huh? I bet. What happens next?
We go somewhere.
Where do you go?
I don't know.
Oh, can you tell me? Relax.
That's okay.
Do you want to go to your cabin for a minute? You're okay. You're right here with me. Let's go to your cabin for a minute. You're okay. All right. And then what happens?
Really?
Do you know where?
No, it's far away.
It's far away.
Yeah.
Do you know what happens then?
We go back.
You go back?
Yeah.
Do you know how long you're with them?
No. No.
And then what happened?
They leave.
What did you do then?
I woke up.
And you wake up?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Very good. So, Steve, I'm going to count. You'll find that with every number that I say, you'll find yourself coming back. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. So, do you remember what you talked to me about?
Yeah, everything.
You do? Good. Is that stuff that you had remembered previously?
Not really.
So it's not what you would have thought?
No, I've seen pictures and images and I hadn't seen before, and it's kind of weird. I just could remember it, you know? I knew something wasn't right, but I never knew what. That light, that's across the river.
The white one?
Yeah, the other light's across the river right there. That's one of their lights. Over here. Here you go. That one straight ahead of me, that's ground zero. That's where they're at in the woods. You can send somebody over there to start walking. When they get so close, it'll go out.
Hey, guys, stay here. I'm going to go check this out.
Just walk out that way. Just keep walking across the gravel bar, down the hillside. Just keep going.
It's just a house. We debunked the first one, debunked this one. I don't want to necessarily discredit what he's saying, but I'm not too sure what's going on. Stop a second.
Shh, shh. There's something over there. Is that a dog?
Dogs apparently can see and hear them, and you can kind of pretty much tell where there's activity by the sound of dogs.
Dan headed back already towards the truck. We're gonna set up a trail cam over there. I think if something comes through here, we're gonna catch it.
Hey, Dad, come here.
What do you got?
When I was walking out that direction by myself, I saw a red moving light right above the ground off in the woods. It was for about a second and a half, 2 seconds, enough to where I can catch it, look at it, and then it went off. So then I went off in that direction, trying to find it, and I couldn't find anything.
You're not going to.
I don't know what that was, so.
The red light's a warning. It's like when you've crossed the line, or you've gone too far, you're going too close, or you're causing too much commotion.
How far away from you do you think the light was?
At first I was like, okay, that was probably a brake light from that street. But then once you get down in there and look up, the street is elevated. So it would have had to been in that draw that we were just walking in. I don't know what that was.
I've heard that many times. Don't know what that was.
I haven't seen you like this. I mean, you're the skeptical, and you actually saw something out there, huh?
I don't know. You know, now that I think about it, I might have been a little quick to write Steve off. But I saw a red light in the woods. We need to see what else is out here.
I caught something up there.
Dan?
Do you have a light with you?
Nope.
Saw a little speck of light right here.
A little tiny white one.
A little tiny one. Right there. Now, when I first saw that through my viewfinder, these lights clearly are house lights, and that's why I was looking through my lens, but I could have sworn you had a flashlight.
No.
And you don't have a flashlight on you.
No.
The hell was that?
Is that something that you see?
Yeah. Yeah, you see the little white light. It seems like the closer they are to you, the dimmer the light.
Oh, my God. Nice.